You know, another thing, want to backtrack for a second.
See these pictures?
Yeah. You notice some big difference?
Yeah, because see the doors, the bays are like wider than this.
Well, look on the second floor.
Yeah, there's three doors and not there's one.
Okay, well, there's four windows there, there's seven there. See, that's a sleeping horse. What happened was this, the easiest way to explain it, this is 1908.
Yeah.
Okay, then World War II, they tore off all this facade, it's called a facade. They tore that off and then this is what was left. Okay, see they even tore off the bell tower. Okay, then in 1990, we put this all back to original. Okay. So, of course, the only difference is it's different colors.
Now I'm wondering, why would you take it off in the bush
basket? I'll tell you why. Because the mortar, you know what mortar is? When they lay bricks, you put cement, mortar, that was falling out of the joints. So it was unstable, so the city said, all right, keep the engine house and we'll tear that stuff off. Okay? So that's why they did. So thank goodness they didn't tear down the whole building, right?
Because
otherwise, we wouldn't have any of this.
No, we wouldn't.
Okay, did you know the horses used to pull fire equipment? So yeah, because you just told me.
Yeah.
Okay, did you know the firefighters pulled equipment to the fire before they used horses? Did you know that? You know firefighters pulled equipment? Yes? Okay. So if you look around, we actually have five pieces of hand-drawn equipment. Okay, this is a hook and ladder truck. What they did, obviously they didn't have Christmas stuff on them. But two guys would steer, then see the rope, see how long it is, so that it pulls out about there. So the guys get a bunch of guys, and they grab the rope, and run down the street with this as fast as people can pull, as fast as people can run, pull a 1-ton equipment to the fire to a few miles an hour.
On that truck over there, right there, not the old fashioned ones, but the one right over there, like the gap one.
Well, that's the play area.
I know you can turn on the lights, but can you also turn on like the siren?
There's a recording of voices and the siren on there. We'll get to that.
We'll get to that.
We'll get to that. That's the grand finale.
It's at the end.
Okay, yeah, that's at the end. It's a hook and ladder truck, hose cart. See this here? Look at this one.
Yep.
Hose cart.
Like there was a tower.
Okay, we're going to talk about that in a minute. There's two pumpers. There's a big green one and a blue and white one. And that's six people to operate then, and about 18 to 20 for that. And then, see the red one in the corner?
Yeah.
That's called a chemical engine. So what that did, adults would understand, is sulfuric acid, baking soda, water. And that makes a chemical reaction. And it, so see, that didn't have a pump on it. Doesn't have a pump, so the chemical reaction pushes the water out the hose. Okay, your dad will understand. When you're a little bit older, maybe you'll understand that.
You always watch the video.
Okay, let me turn on this light. Back over here. This talks about water mains and fire plugs. Okay, and those were used with these old pumpers. But if you look at that, water mains were trees. Okay, they cut down trees, they drill through it, water runs through it. Okay, nowadays they're big steel pipes. They're underground, you don't see. Right? When you turn on the water in your house, it's coming from a pipe that's underground. When you turn on the fire hydrant, come from that same pipe that's underground. It's all hooked up, okay? But in the old days, it sat on the ground by the sidewalk. Now this is especially in the south, southern climates. So if you lived in Savannah, Georgia, this is what it would look like. If you lived in Maine, you're gonna have cold winters. They were buried. So say we're in Savannah, Georgia, and we have a fire. So we take our drill bit and you have to drill through it. Okay. You ever seen a Wild West movie? Wild West movie.
I'm not a movie person.
You ever been to a farm?
No.
You ever seen a picture of a horse or a cow drinking out of a trough? Now you have a homework assignment. When you go home, Dad will help you look it up. So this is a trough, kind of like what horses and cows and pigs drink out of, so the water goes in that. They can take buckets and dip that in there and stir right on the fire. Or they supply this pumper truck with water. Okay? And actually they have a whole long line of people. Everybody in town had to have two of these buckets.
Yeah.
So when there was a fire, everybody comes, basically, pretty much everybody, to put out the fire. So you got a big pile of buckets here. So you're dipping buckets in water. You got a line of people. You might have 50 people going to that truck there. So you dip a bucket in the water and you give it to the person, he gives it to the next person. So on and so forth. Okay, can you picture that?
Yeah.
All right. When they're done, they're all done, they have to plug up the hole. Okay, because what happens to water in the wintertime?
It goes away.
What happens to water in the winter? Like it's real cold. What does it do?
It's real cold.
What did the water in our pool do?
Turns into ice.
Ice. So if we let the water, if it's 20 below zero out.
Yeah, and if it turns into ice, you can't put out a fire of ice.
Well, but stop and think, also, the water's coming out of the water main, it's 20 below zero. What's going to happen?
It's all going
to happen. What's going to happen to the water on the road?
It's going to turn into ice.
Okay, so what happens when the pedestrians and the horses are...
They're going
to slip and fall, exactly. So we plug up the hole. Okay, what happens to water in summertime?
It stays the water.
Right, so you're just wasting water, right? If you let it go all over the place, right? Okay, so that's why we plug up the hole.